The femoral artery, which is a continuation of the external iliac deep to the inguinal ligament, crosses the femoral triangle and the subsartorial canal and then enter into the adductor hiatus to continuous within the popliteal fossa as femoral artery, which crosses the popliteal fossa from above downwards till it reaches the lower border of popliteus muscle, where it bifurcates into its terminal branches, the tibial arteries, the anterior and mid and posterior tibial arteries. The posterior tibial artery runs between the superficial and deep compartment within the back of the leg till it reaches the point behind the medial malleolus here, and it gives it its terminal branches, which are called plantar arteries, which will supply the foot. The venous drainage of the lower limb has two groups of veins. Superficial veins start from the dorsum of the foot as the dorsal venous arch. Two big veins, one passes medially in front of the medial malleolus, called great saphenous vein, and the other passes behind the lateral malleolus, called small saphenous vein. The small ends at the popliteal fossa by joining the popliteal vein, and the long great saphenous passes or crosses the leg, most of the thigh, and end at the roof of the femoral triangle by entering the saphenous opening and drains into the femoral vein. In this model, we can see the great saphenous vein passes on the medial side of the leg and then crosses the thigh to end at the femoral vein. And also, we can see the small saphenous passes behind the lateral malleolus, crosses the back of the leg, and pierces the roof of the popliteal fossa to end in the popliteal vein.